Hello, welcome to Big Bang Radio Spotlights. This is a show where we talk to independent artists from all around the world all about their music and their process for making it. I'm your host, Isaac Anderson, and today I get to sit down with musician Olivia Lunny. Without any further ado, here's the interview. Olivia, thank you so much for joining us today. We really do appreciate it. I want to start at the beginning of your musical journey, just like we do with all the other artists that we talk to on the show. So the first question I want to ask you is, what is your earliest musical memory?
Thank you so much for having me. And my earliest musical memory would have to be my dad played You Are My Sunshine on the guitar, and I would always ask him to strum it while he played the chords. So I'd sit beside him and I'd strum the guitar. So music was definitely around me a lot from an early age.
Yeah, I that's something I read about you, is that your dad taught you lessons when you were about 12 or so. So it sounds like music's always kind of been a part of your family. And so I know you started playing guitar then, but like, when did you start singing? Like, because you have a really awesome voice. I imagine it had to start somewhere.
Yeah, so I think everything kind of happened simultaneously. I remember getting my first musical solo when I was in grade 2. So I was super young. I was probably like 7 or 8 years old, maybe even younger. And it was the Christmas pageant, and I had one of the lead solos. And I remember being terrified, but practicing in my room so no one could hear me. And then I was finally so excited when I got to perform that. So I think that kind of sparked the wanting in my heart to perform.
You're not only an amazing vocalist and musician, but you're also an amazing songwriter. And it sounds like you've been playing music and you've been writing songs since around that time also. And mm-hmm. I believe you wrote your first song at 13. Do you remember that song at all? Like, I'm not going to ask you to sing it or anything, but I'm just curious, like, what does that song mean to you all these years later? Like, how do you feel like it, like, did it springboard you into writing more? Like, was it just kind of like that was just something you did and you discovered it later? I don't know. What in your mind, how did that work for you?
Yeah, no, I'm happy you asked. I think I used to just write down in my journal, like, little poems and little rhymes and stuff, and then I would put those to music. And the first time I actually wrote a song, I wrote it. It's kind of cheesy, but I wrote it for my friend. I remember she was going through a really hard time. Something happened at home, so I wrote her a song. Then I showed her that song. And I just remember her being so taken aback and so excited and happy, and that kind of changed her mood. So I think that's when I really realized that music truly does have the power to make an impact on people. And that's when I started diving into it deeper as almost like a form of therapy to just navigate high school.
Yeah, it's always a really interesting time. I find a lot of artists really start thriving around that time just because it's such like you're kind of finding out who you are. You're kind of figuring out what you're going to be able to do. So that's super wonderful. That's super wonderful. And it sounds like music is really ingrained in who you are. And you've kind of known that for quite some time. But was there a moment in your mind that you just kind of like it was solidified where you're like, you know what? This music thing is not a hobby. This isn't just a like. This is a love. This is what I'm going to pursue.
For sure. So I think by about grade 12, I had been gigging in local coffee shops, playing the local folk fest in Winnipeg, where I'm from. And around that time, I didn't really know what I wanted to do career-wise with school. School wasn't my favorite thing. I didn't really enjoy high school that much. And music was just this huge passion of mine in life. And I had some conversations with my family and kind of just said, I want to do this. I want to try this. And we made the decision, let's try it for a year. And then I can always go to school if that year kind of doesn't work out. And I haven't really gone to school since. So hopefully upwards from here. To see you happier with her. To see you happier. It hurts to know how bright I need you now that I am sad to see you. Watching go one by one, falling slow. They all did what they do. You may love black and white. They all did what they do. They all fell except for you.
Research on you for this interview, I found like your songs are really just like they're super infectious. I found myself humming them later in the day just because they
were just. I'm so happy to hear that. Thank you.
Oh yeah, no problem. I mean, yeah, for real. I mean, they're very catchy and they're super infectious and they're just really well done, really well produced, and really well written. And I'm just wondering, a lot of artists have different methods of writing and everything. And as a musician myself, I'm really curious, like. Do you have set times that you like to create? Like, are you really regimented with your writing, or is it like, is it really kind of more spontaneous than that?
Yeah, so I mean, I'm definitely working on more of a segmented way of writing because it comes to me very spontaneously, which is a blessing and a curse sometimes. So I never know when a song's going to hit. Or in writing sessions, obviously, usually there's a lot of creative juices flowing. But in terms of just writing myself, a lot of the times I'll just sit down with my guitar. Usually at nighttime, I find I'm a bit more inspired. And that's when I write a lot of ideas. Sometimes on the airplane as well, as inconvenient as that is. I'll sit down and I'll hum something into my phone, or I'll write down some poems or words that are heavy on my mind. But yeah, it's a very kind of random, sporadic process for me.
Do you find yourself doing a lot of more like maybe like voice memos, or like maybe there's a phrase you want? Like, do the lyrics kind of drive the music for you, or like does the music drive the lyrics? I don't know. Maybe it's different every single time, but I'm curious.
Yeah, a lot of the times for me, the lyrics will come first when I'm not around an instrument. But if I pick up an instrument, then usually the melody comes up first. And then I kind of pair two and two together.
Heard that. It's super weird how that works. It's almost like you just kind of like a word can just inspire a chord, or a chord can just like, you kind of have this phonetic thing. So that's super, super cool. I'm curious how you can ride on the airplane. I'm sure that's an interesting process. I want to hop on to one of the things I discovered about you is that you were on a show called The Launch, which I never heard of originally, but looking up, it's a very big show in Canada, and it's I believe it's on CTV up there, and you won the whole competition, which is super awesome. So what was that experience like? How did you get involved in the show, and like, what did it feel like to be like, you won, like you actually won this thing?
I know, it's still pretty surreal to even think about that experience. But basically, I was approached by an A&R from the show. They sent me an email, hey, you should apply for the show. Like, you never know what will happen. And I don't think I would have applied if I wouldn't have gotten that email, because I was kind of stuck on me and my guitar thing. So I applied, thought nothing of it, and then got accepted for the show, came to Toronto, did the whole filming process. And then, yeah, fortunately, I won, and the show really did essentially launch my career and connect me with so many incredible musicians and industry people, and really acted as a platform to, I guess, elevate my career. So I'm really grateful for that experience.
Wonderful, wonderful. Well, congratulations. I know it was a while ago, but that's super
you.
Cool.
Thank you so much.
The thrill's never going to go away. Well, now I want to hop on to your debut album, album number one. It's out now, all streaming platforms, super awesome stuff on there. And what was the process of making that like? I imagine, I don't know if you did any of that during COVID. I'm assuming you probably had to. How was that process like, trying to do that during those kind of weird times that we had last year? And from the songwriting perspective and the creative perspective, what does this album mean to you?
Yeah, so luckily we did have half the album written before we all kind of went into lockdown, so that was a blessing. But then we did have to do some virtual stuff just to finish everything throughout the quarantine period. So luckily for Zoom, and we did a bunch of sessions like that. But I think nothing really beats an in-person session where you have the environment and you can kind of go off each other. But for me, this album is really just an introduction into who is Olivia Lunny for the listener, because I've released singles and I released an EP, but this is a way more in-depth look at who I am as a person, as a writer, and just musically. There's some more pop songs, there's some ballads, and it's just, I guess, a nice little taste of my artistry in different ways.
Wonderful, wonderful. Well, if people want to keep up with all the things that you are up to right now and what you're going to be doing in the future, how can they find you online?
You can find me on any social media platform at Olivia Lunny. My last name is Lunny, and on Facebook, it's Olivia Lunny Music. So check it out to stay up to date.
Wonderful. Well, Olivia, this was such a treat to talk to you. Thank you so much. But before you go, I got one more question for you. And now, I don't know if you've ever seen a Big Bang Radio spotlight before, but I'm a musician, but I'm also a lover of film. And I believe those two worlds are not too far away from each other. And I always ask the artists this before they go, because it varies so much from artist to artist. And I feel like we have a strong connection in film as musicians. So what is your favorite movie?
I would have to, it's so hard. I guess I'll pick one. But one of my favorite movies is 500 Days of Summer. I think it's such a great film, and I won't give away the ending, but it's just a lovely, bittersweet ending. It's not your typical rom-com, and I think it's very well done.
Thanks to Olivia for sitting down with us and talking all about her music. If you guys want to see more interviews just like this, you can find us online at Studio 67 NCC. Thank you all for watching. I'm Isaac Anderson, and until next time, stay lovely.